Now, here's an awful fact. A dead sperm whale washed up on a beach in Indonesia with 6 kilograms of plastic in its stomach.
That's horrible. And it highlights an issue that's really close to my heart. My sister and I founded an online campaign called Kids Against Plastic.
And that's mainly because of how plastic's polluting the oceans, right?
Exactly. And I've been digging up some of the top facts about why it's such a mega issue. One thing nearly everyone agrees on: plastic is fantastic. We produce nearly 400 million tons of it every year. It can be molded into all kinds of shapes, sizes, and colors to create everyday items. But nearly half the plastic we produce is made into items only used once, like crisp packets, water bottles, and carrier bags. And those single-use plastics are a real problem. Every minute, the equivalent of a rubbish truck of plastic enters our oceans. It's either blown there off beaches or even flushed down the toilet. This isn't an island. It's floating plastic, known as a trash island. Plastic doesn't decay naturally, and it's our marine life that pays the price. Every year, 100,000 animals die from eating plastic or getting caught up in it.
So we set a challenge for you and your sister to try and live without plastic. How did it go?
Trust me, it's a lot harder than it sounds. Check this out.
This morning, we're doing a plastic-free challenge, which means we can't use a single piece of plastic.
To wash my hair today, instead of using the regular products packaged in plastic, I've used a plastic-free shampoo bar.
I need to find some natural fibre clothing so I can get out of this plastic fleecy onesie.
Polyester. Acrylic. Polyester.
I can't dry my hair. And I can't brush it either, because they're both made of plastic.
Regular plastic toothbrushes and toothpastes are a no-no, so instead we're using bamboo ones with these tooth tabs, which are made from charcoal, and you chew them and they act as a toothpaste. The only problem is they don't taste that nice.
Most breakfast items are packaged in a lot of plastic, so we thought ahead and last night we made our own fresh bread.
Not quite as convenient, but it actually tastes a lot nicer.
We're just heading off into town now to see if I can get a wooden hairbrush to actually brush my hair.
And so we can get to a bite to eat and a drink.
Baby, we can't go in the van, it's got plastic.
Well, we failed at finding a hairbrush. I mean, they're all made of plastic.
Success!
Costa gave my drink in my reusable mug, and they even gave a discount, which is a bonus.
Can't do my homework if the pen's made of plastic.
No escape from the dreaded homework, or more importantly, plastic.
Yeah, unfortunately not. I asked the Prime Minister what the government's doing to help.
Prime Minister, my sister and I founded a campaign against single-use plastic pollution, so we really like your aim to tackle avoidable plastic waste out of the UK by 2042. But we're a bit worried that this date is too far away in the future.
The first thing I'd like to say is a huge thank you to you and your sister for the campaign that you've started against single-use plastic. So 2042, yes, it's a long way away, but it doesn't mean we're not doing anything now, because we've started taking action. The 5p charge we introduced on plastic carrier bags means that we've now had 9 billion fewer plastic bags on our streets. We've brought in a world-leading ban on microbeads, and we're putting plans together to ban plastic straws and cotton buds as well.
OK, well, that's definitely a start, but what does the Labour leader Jeremy Corbyn plan to do?
Taking a plastic bottle, taking a swig from it and throwing it in a bin means it will either end up incinerated or landfill. We have to be conscious not to use plastic and also to reuse it, but also to have a deposit scheme on bottles and to have better recycling facilities in this country. There are at the moment over 40 different recycling systems in local authorities across England and Wales. It's far too many. We need a much simpler system.
For loads more on what you can do to cut down on single-use plastics, visit Sky Ocean Rescue.